Welcome to the lecture number 3. Myself P.S. Sogule from Sharad Institute of Technology, College of Engineering, Yatra. So the conduction is nothing but transfer of energy from the more energetic particle of a substance to the adjacent less energetic one as a result of interaction between the particles. Remember that? Without appreciable movement of the molecule in the substance. Conduction can take place in solid, liquid and gases. No doubt in liquid and gases, main part of the heat transfer is because of the convection, but some part is because of the conduction. In solid, conduction is due to lattice vibration and transport of free electrons. And in case of liquid and gases, due to the collision and diffusion of the molecules during the random motion. Now let us consider, this is the metallic rod, and if I heat this metallic rod at one end, by our observation we can tell that heat will flow from this end to the other end, right? Now let's say these are the faces F1 and F2. So heat will flow from F1 to F2. Now let us assume something, or let us consider the material is homogeneous. Means it is structurally and chemically homogeneous throughout the length. And we will consider it as a steady state condition, means there is a no change in temperature with respect to time. If I take particular instance, and at that instant there will be no change in temperature with respect to time after heating. Now unidirectional heat flows from F1 to F2 in a longitudinal way. Temperature gradient is constant, and there is a no internal heat generation by means of chemically. There is a no internal heat generation inside of this metallic rod. And the bonding surfaces F1 and F2 are isothermal, means there will not be any losses of heat from F1 to the surrounding, or from F2 to the surrounding. Now if I consider these are the some basics, or you can say these are the conditions, then in engineering term we called it as assumptions. Now by taking these assumptions in mind, scientist Fourier developed an equation for the heat distribution. So let us see what's the Fourier law. So Fourier law of heat conduction says that the rate of flow of heat through a simple homogeneous solid is directly proportional to the area of that section at right angles to the direction of heat flow, and to change of temperature with respect to the path of heat flow. Let us take the previous one. Here the area means this cross sectional area, because heat flows longitudinally, so the perpendicular area is nothing but this one F1, right? So mathematically we can write it here, Q, which is the heat flow rate, is directly proportional to area and temperature difference with respect to the path of heat flow. Now here in this term, Q is nothing but heat flow through a body per unit time, and the unit for that is watt. A is the surface area in meter square. Now here remember that, why I have said here surface area, instead of that you can put here cross sectional area also, remember, the area should be, area of section should be right angle to the direction of heat flow. Why I have called it here surface area? Because I have taken the area of F1. So you can take here cross sectional area of heat flow. DT is the temperature difference of the faces of the block of thickness dx, which is in degree Celsius, or you may take in Kelvin. Dx is the length of body in direction of heat flow in meters. So I can write it here, Q is equal to K, which is the constant of proportionality, into dt upon dx. So let's see. If I heat this at point F1, it will flows to the face F2. So Q is equal to Ka into dt upon dx. Now here A, I have taken this one, area. Right? This one is the area, cross-sectional area. If I take here the area, then I will call it as cross-section. Now here also, I will consider it as surface area of this face. But remember that you have to take the area which is perpendicular to the direction of heat flow. Now in this, the F1 temperature, if I consider T1 and F2 at F2, if I consider temperature T2, then you know that if I heat this rod at this end, the temperature at this point is much more greater than this one. And heat will flow from higher temperature to the lower temperature. That ultimately means our T1 is greater than T2. Now here dT means the temperature difference of the final minus initial. So I have to take here T2 minus T1. Remember this one. You have to take the final temperature minus the initial temperature. Now in this case, since T2 is less than T1, from T1 only we are going to supply the heat. So T1 is greater than T2. That means our dT terms will be automatically negative. And to compensate this negative sign over here, we have to write it, this equation, in this form. Q is equal to minus Ka dT upon dx. Remember that this minus sign is because to maintain the sign convention of Q. Right? Now this K means the thermal conductivity. Now here dx means the total length along which the heat will flow. Here it is, dx. Now this K is the thermal conductivity, and if I rearrange the term to find the definition of thermal conductivity, I can write it here in this way. K is equal to, I will neglect the term minus, and K is equal to Q upon A into dx upon dt. So in a simple terms, I can write the definition of thermal conductivity as the amount of energy conducted through a body of unit area, unit thickness in a unit time, when the difference between the phases causing heat flow is of unit temperature difference. Means when we get K is equal to 1, when all these terms will be at 1. And let's derive the unit for the thermal conductivity, Q, which is in watt, area, which is in meter square, length, which is in meter, and the temperature difference, you can take it in degree Celsius or Kelvin, which is same. So this will be the unit for thermal conductivity. वैट पर मीटर केल्विन और वैट पर मीटर डिग्री सेल्सियस. सो लेट्स सी द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी विच इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मटेरियल. एक्चुअली इट इज डिपेंड अपॉन द मटेरियल स्ट्रक्चर, डेंसिटी ऑफ मटेरियल, मॉइस्चर कंटेंट, ऑपरेटिंग कंडीशंस. सो हियर इट इज द वन एग्जाम्पल फॉर ईच एंड एवरी मटेरियल. आई हैव पुट ओवर हियर द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी. फॉर कॉपर इट इज 399 वैट पर मीटर केल्विन एंड फॉर द स्टेनलेस स्टील इट इज 50.1 वैट पर मीटर केल्विन. सो व्हाट थिंग यू हैव टू ऑब्जर्व इन दैट, द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी इज हाइएस्ट इन द प्योर मेटल एंड डिक्रीज विथ इंक्रीज इन इम्प्यूरिटी. एज यू नो वी हैव टू पुट द इम्प्यूरिटीज इन द प्योर मेटल सो दैट वी विल गेट द डिजायर्ड कॉम्बिनेशन और द डिजायर्ड आउटपुट. सो कॉपर, गोल्ड, एल्यूमिनियम, आयरन आर द प्योर मेटल्स एंड यू कैन सी हियर द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी इज हाई इन दैट केस. एज वी गो ऑन इंक्रीजिंग द इम्प्यूरिटी द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी डिक्रीजेस कंटिन्यूअसली. देन सेकेंड थिंग, थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी ऑफ पोरस मटेरियल इज डिपेंड अपॉन द गैस और लिक्विड प्रेजेंट इन दैट वॉइड्स. द रेशियो ऑफ थर्मल एंड इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटीज इज द सेम फॉर ऑल मेटल्स एट द सेम टेम्परेचर एंड दैट द रेशियो इज डायरेक्टली प्रपोर्शनल टू द एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर ऑफ मेटल. लेट्स सी के दिस विल बी द इक्वेशन वेयर के इज द थर्मल कंडक्टिविटी, टी इज द एब्सोल्यूट टेम्परेचर एंड द इलेक्ट्रिकल कंडक्टिविटी दैट इज रो दैट इज सिग्मा. Now K upon delta that is C is equal to Lorentz number which is equal to 2.45 into 10 raised to minus 8 watt ohm per Kelvin square. Now electrical analogy. Thermal system. In thermal system, heat flow is directly proportional to the temperature difference. So I can write here in Q is equal to KA into temperature difference divided by the length. That means heat flow rate Q is equal to temperature difference divided by dx upon KA. If I analog this with the electrical system, in electrical system, electric current is directly proportional to the potential difference, which means current I is equal to potential difference divided by electric resistance. So if I compare these two equations, I can say that dx upon Ka, which is nothing but the electric resistance, we can analog this one. And that's why we call thermal resistance, that is currently we are studying conduction, so the thermal conduction resistance is equal to dx upon Ka. You can represent this in this form. When temperature T1 is greater than T2, then heat will flow from T1 to T2 and the material resistance or thermal resistance which is equal to dx upon Ka. The reciprocal of thermal resistance is called thermal conductance. Thank you and stay connected.